Okay, I'm going to go straight across to our special guest this morning. We have the NCP leader. We've got the former aviation minister, Mr. Praful Patel, joining us live on CNN News 18. Thank you very much, Mr. Praful Patel. I'm going to first focus only on Maharashtra. We've been seeing a huge spike in cases in Maharashtra. Mumbai continues to remain worrisome. We've also seen that tussle which has taken place between the state government and the central government on the BJP. We've also heard the Home Minister telling us that this is not a time for us to meddle into the affairs of the state government. As long as they are happy with each other, these blame game on the central government that we are trying to topple the state government is wrong. What is your reaction to that?
So first, coming to your question about the number of cases in Maharashtra, No doubt that Maharashtra records, and Mumbai especially, recorded the highest number of COVID-19 cases. You have to look at the profile of Mumbai also. It's an international city. A lot of people travel to and from India to overseas and back. Also, the fact is Mumbai is a very densely populated city. The topography of Mumbai is very different from most other Indian cities. So you have to give that second consideration. And more importantly, when you talk of the number of cases, you must also understand that I think that testing rate in Mumbai and in Maharashtra has been the highest. I'll give you one statistic. 77 testing centers until yesterday in the state, and that number will go up to 100. Count any other state in India, without exception, which has this number of testing centers. You won't get any number close to this at all. Therefore, you have to appreciate that on one side, if the testing is higher, the detection of cases is higher. And the more important statistic, I think, you know, all of us in India, I'm not only talking vis-a-vis Mumbai, but all of us in India will have to, I think, come to terms that COVID-19 is here to stay. And the fact is that out of, say, the 70,000 cases we talk in Maharashtra, more than 35,000 people have already been cured and gone home. So, or they were at home itself. They never really needed to go to a hospital. So when we talk of cases, we should look at 35,000 cases. Out of the 35,000 cases, how many are asymptomatic? The figure in Maharashtra or Mumbai is approximately 85%. That means people don't even realize that best they need a Crocin, paracetamol or something and they'll be fine. So the number of, the cases vis-a-vis the population, the density of Mumbai and the state and the kind of geography. You see, we have to consider all these aspects and the aggressive testing which we are doing here. That's the most important factor. And now coming to the other question, what you were saying about state and center and all that. I think, you see, I would look at it in a larger perspective. The first lockdown came at the instance of the central government nationally. There was a decision that overnight they will decide to shut down all activity in India, including transportation. That, of course, led to so many problems in the country, which we have all seen over the last 2 months. I need not go into that again and again. I don't even want to go into this blame game because, you know, this is very nice, you know, when somebody from the opposition is sitting. So, you know, each other is a blame game. I think at this moment, a person like me would look at this as a national calamity, a big problem, not only for India, but also for the world. And therefore, in our context, I would say that it needs to be addressed very effectively and very aggressively. Initial lockdown in the country, my assessment is needed to be done. Now, how it needed to be done, there could be little difference of opinion, whether trains needed to be kept open, some transportation for people to reach their own homes for a few days. Now, these are all debatable things. Now, if you want to go back into hindsight and again, you know, try to do a post-mortem of everything, you will find so many things where whether state or center could have done right or wrong. Let's look at the larger picture. I think the lockdown was a must. Lockdown was a must for two reasons. Not only just to arrest the spread of the disease, which is very, very important because you had to break the, at least reduce the speed with which it would have been transmitted. The second more important thing, according to me, was within these 60 days, we've created enough hospital infrastructure, isolation beds, ICUs, oxygen masks, oxygen cylinders, ventilators, also the fact that PPE kits and so many things, we really didn't have them. And again here, you know, a lot of people say Mumbai, this is happening or that is happening. My answer is, was anybody in the world prepared for such a pandemic? The answer is no. Hmm. You saw scenes in Italy, you saw scenes in the United States, in England, and so many places where the best of hospitals and the best of facilities were not enough.
But you
know, because
Mr.
the
Patel,
number of cases suddenly came up.
But Mr. Patel, I'm talking about, I'm sure you've seen those protests on the street. I mean, the former Chief Minister Devendra Fadnavis protests on the roads, saying it's an immature government, inexperienced government. And you people hit back by saying that the central government is trying to topple up us. Where is that allegation coming from? Because that's the allegation which the Home Minister has clarified.
I think a lot of spokesmen get into the act and they, you know, up the ante. That is my own assessment. There are many overzealous spokesmen on both sides who create all these kind of new issues when none exist.
So you agree with Mr. Amit Shah that they were not trying to topple the government? You agree?
No. Let me explain what I'm trying to say.
Go ahead.
Why did Mr. The Devendra Fadnavis led BJP in Maharashtra at this time need to protest about something which is going on in the state? Is this the time? Was this the time to even demonstrate or to show? There are the entire police machinery, poor people are, you know, working 24/7. Doctors, paramedics, you name it. I mean, the whole government machinery is overburdened with so much of this problem. And is this the time to protest? The answer is absolutely, it's right, it's clear on the wall. So why did they do it? And then obviously when somebody will, you know, do this, there will always be question phrase, say from somebody like you, who will say, okay, is this, does it mean that, you know, the central government is behind this move? They have clarified. I think it the matter should be put to rest there. Mm-hmm. But I personally don't feel that the BJP in Maharashtra needed to have done this demonstration. And I'm telling you, it was not in good taste. I don't think the people of Maharashtra even appreciated it or gave it much, support. And that itself, should be an eye-opener that people are, you know, struggling. This is a time, it's not just about health pandemic. It is, of course, a health pandemic. But at the same time, if you look at the kind of the scale and the enormity of the problem which the country is facing and will face in the years to come because of this lockdown and closure and this entire, the economic slowdown, we have a lot on our plate and we have so much to worry that we shouldn't be getting into this petty politics of calling a bandh in Maharashtra and protest in Maharashtra, especially during a time when we are neck deep in trouble.
But you don't think that government is under threat in Maharashtra? Your government stable?
You see, if the Home Minister of India has correctly said that there is no move and there is no issue like this, then I think this debate is not necessary. But at the same time, if you just go hypothetically, in state after state of India, there have been cases and there have been spike in cases even as of yesterday. Does it mean, I see the news and through that only we come to know most of the things of the country today. You see how, Delhi, they opened up again, they had a spike. In Gujarat, there was a spike yesterday. In Tamil Nadu, there was a spike. Does it mean that those governments are not doing enough, or does it mean that it's a case for those governments to be taken over? In fact, I'm telling you, this time, people will not appreciate any kind of politics, whether it is, from either at the state level or the central level. People want to move on with their lives. People are worried. I'm telling you, I'm not just talking of people worried about their health. Of course, physical health, safety is very important. People are concerned and they're careful. But people are thinking now beyond. See, 2.5 months into a lockdown, people now think beyond what is going to come. What is their life going to be tomorrow? Are their jobs going to remain? Are they going to the businesses going to survive? Are their shops going to have customers?
Okay.
Have enough problems. Everybody's now, this 2.5 months is also putting people thinking the other way around.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so I guess this
and
is
I
not
think
the
this
time.
is something we as a nation, and therefore this is a time I think we have to really work hard to restore the confidence in the people.
All
that's
right.
Why when I said in the beginning that, you know, we talk of 70,000 cases in Maharashtra, why don't we talk of 35,000 cases? What about the 35,000 who've gone back home? Mm-hmm. Yes, there have been few deaths, but deaths are in I'm not trying to say that any death is acceptable. We certainly cannot afford to lose human lives because of any pandemic. But at the same time, there are some people who have comorbidities, people who are older. They have to be more careful, of course, and they have to be, you know, looked after very well.
Okay.
But unfortunately, some people do get it. And if they have it and they have fallen prey to that disease, we cannot now completely say that, you know, we will have a complete lockdown forever.
Oh,
we
right.
need to open up. We have to move forward. And I'm telling you, this mm-hmm. life versus livelihood, this phrase has been used often in the last few days. Mm-hmm. I've been seeing by many people. And I think it's relevant. Mm-hmm. I would look at it this way, that, you know, we have, fortunately in the world, one of the best demographics. We have the youngest population.
Mm-hmm.
Our average age in India is 28 years. And above the age of 60 or 65, we have only about 8% of our population. So that, I think, is a fantastic news for India. And if you see this disease and its universal spread and probably some of the data which we okay. get, I think most people above 60 are more vulnerable. And therefore, I think it's also a good case for India to open up the country for younger people especially.
Okay, fair enough. That's a fair enough point. But thank you very much, Mr. Patel. I'm not going to take too much of your time. The point made is that this is not the time to play politics. Thank you very much for speaking to CNN News 18. So that was the NCP chief, former aviation minister, Mr. Praful Patel, speaking out on our exclusive interview with the Home Minister, Amit Shah. Well, we're going to come back after this short break.